Good morning, Mr. Rector Magnificus, and members of the plenary committee, and staff, and students. My thesis is titled "Is the Changing Nature of Work in Mongolia: Potential Informal and Migrant Workers." This research covers three periods: socialist transition and open market system, and focuses more on periods since transition away from socialism. Under influence of perestroika of 1987 in Russia, Mongolia made peaceful movement to democracy. However, due to collapse of former socialist system, Mongolia experienced economic crisis, and in this figure, there was a dramatic decline in growth of GDP during 1990 and 1995. People responded to this economic crisis demographically, and population growth declined in 1995 dramatically also. And among others, birth and marriage declined, migration increased. Even after transition, macro-level imbalance continued. Among others, if we look by sector, economic sector, then economic crisis resulted in deindustrialization in Mongolia. Together with manufacturing sector, construction, transport, and communication sectors experienced decline. After transition, construction sector was most dynamic, while manufacturing and agricultural sector were fluctuating. After a clear crisis in transition period, in general, there was a recovery of pre-1990 patterns of growth, even if there was a macroeconomic balance continued. But these thesis explores whether there has been a fundamental shift in the livelihoods of Mongolian people. We mentioned it earlier that migration was one of the demographic responses to economic crisis. And migration increased dramatically. Migration increased by 2.4 times during the 10 years compared with the last 10 years of socialism. And there were two major streams, migration to Ulaanbaatar and migration to central region where Ulaanbaatar is located. Migration to Ulaanbaatar was the largest stream in the country, and more than half migrants in the 5 years before the census was moved to the Ulaanbaatar. As a result of dramatic changes occurred at the macro level, unemployed, informal workers, potential workers, human misery emerged in the country. In contrast with the lifetime security which enjoyed our parents during socialism in Mongolia. If you look at this picture depicts the process of the change in the livelihood. During socialism, people used to employ informal sector and got retired from the formal sector, therefore people tend to have a lifetime security. During transition period, due to privatization, some people got unemployed and informal workers emerged. After transition, the newly emerged unemployed informal workers were increasing. On top of that, potential workers emerged. In other words, in the open market system, during the transition to the open market system, there was a shift from lifetime security to human misery. So in order to study diverse and complex livelihoods which has emerged since transition, and also reasons for migration to Ulaanbaatar, a primary survey was conducted, and it was titled Migration, Formal and Informal Employment. And questioning was based on ILO Labor Force Survey and also models of migration questionnaires. And this survey covers major three topics: labor movement, employment, and migration. We used three stages, stratified sampling, and unit of observation was household. Here I put unit of analysis, but unit of observation was household. Unit of analysis was individuals. We conducted the survey in three locations, in Ulaanbaatar in four districts, and Ulaanbaatar is a place of destination, but Uruhangayamuk was chosen as a place of origin, and within the Uruhangayamuk, there was Arvakhiramuk Center and Bayangosum Center, two some centers were selected. As a total, this survey covers 700 households, 400 households in UP, 200 households in IMX Center, and 100 households in Bayangosum, and with 2,145 persons aged 12 and plus were covered. The newly emerged social classes. To capture the newly emerged social classes, the international labor force approach was not sufficient. Therefore, in my household survey, which covered 2,145 persons aged 12 and above, I asked enumerators to print the detailed answers in the giving space in the international questionnaire for all questions on economic activity. Studying these rich answers, I was in a position to convert qualitative data into quantitative data and to capture diverse livelihoods in the statistical data collection. More importantly, I identified potential workers as not economically active persons who have no reason not to work. Also, all types of informal workers were fully captured in the in the data collection, and there was no person who are in working age remained with the under other category. Everybody was captured in the data collection, and potential informal workers were. We found two types of informal workers, informal laborers and informal business workers. Within the informal laborers, we found rotating workers, paid workers, visiting workers, casual workers, and informal business workers was divided as individual business workers, household business workers, and unpaid business workers. More importantly, I did contribution on labor statistics to identify all persons in working age according to workers' status as employed, unemployed, potential workers, and non-workers, based on question on reasons for not working. If we would ask just one more question, do you have a reason which will fully explain for not working, even if you want to work, then yes, I have a reason which I can fully explain, like studying. I'm studying, retired, looking for a person. Then these people become non-worker, and then if people say no, I have no reason not to work. I'm healthy, I'm young, I'm in working. I have a capacity to work. In short, if they have no reason not to work, then we found it as a potential worker. So when I identified potential workers, I tried to understand who were the potential workers. And I found that potential workers risk amortization of human capital and the descent into human misery as they move to different types of potential workers rather than making employment movement. We found three major types of potential workers: discouraged workers, discriminated workers, and failed workers. And if you see that this number, we found 314 potential workers, and out of which 206 was failed workers. In other words, the majority of potential large proportion of the potential workers were failed workers. And these were working in the agricultural sector, in rural area, in livestock rearing. And after the collapse of rural institution in Nigdel, livestock breeding households became individual producers, and they started to survive on their own. And given the harsh climate of Mongolia during winter, minus 20 and snowstorm and all that, these individual households' lack of experience, management, individual household business, and they faced loss of livestock. And after they faced loss of livestock, they have no choice. They carry the gear, and then they move to Ulaanbaatar. In terms of age and sex, potential workers were most likely to be males aged 20 to 39. And if you look at these two graphs, if we use the international standard current method, then we will see that, okay, among unemployed persons, females are more likely to be unemployed. But if you look at the graph of potential workers, then it gives different picture. Potential workers constitute males. And males in prime ages are more likely to have no job. So given this picture that potential workers are more likely to be males in the prime ages, then women have at least 6 burdens in the work market system in Mongolia, in addition to the ordinary burdens like productive and reproductive. In addition to that, the women have a no-salary husband as a burden. And violence, possibly, from non-salary husband, potential worker husband, and obviously unpaid domestic work, and also household management. Also, females during transition tend to face more insecurity, especially those who have got less education. They were more likely to change their jobs and more likely to remain with no job after movement. So potential workers, those who mainly consist of males in prime ages, were also highly they were more likely to involve in migration. And also, highest hidden potential migration was found among potential workers. Out of 125 potential workers, around 40% intend to migrate, but they cannot migrate because they have no money. And if they will have money, they are going to migrate. And apart from potential workers, informal laborers also have a highest hidden potential migration, and major reasons was also no money. And apart from no money, home community was another major reason. And in our survey, showed that in general people are very much attached to the place of origin, and why they move while they are attached to their place of origin? It is because, more interestingly, as we found that reasons for stopping jobs, reasons for not working, and reasons for migration were all entitlement failures in the place of origin. So even if they attached to the place of origin due to the phase of entitlement failures, they are just pushed out of the place. So.
Dear candidates, please respect the time with respect to your introduction and wrap up, because mm-hmm. I would like to start a debate.
Okay. And therefore, in order to reduce migration, and in order to solve prevailing livelihood insecurity, we need to create a local formal employment in the place of origin. and also international organizations, developed countries should redirect the aid and assistance to create an alternative economic sector in rural areas in Mongolia, which also has a relevance for other developing countries.